The next presenter would be Dr. Paurnika Wallad, and she'll be speaking on association of intraocular pressure and retinal nerve fiber layer thickness in pseudoexfoliation patient.
Good evening, everyone. Please. Moving on, pseudoexfoliation syndrome is distinguished by the evolution and the growing accretion of fibrillary deposits. It's characterized by the presence of white, fluffy, dandruff-like material on the pupillary border, lens capsule, or the angles. Apart from raised IOP, various pressure-independent factors like the impaired ocular and retrobulbar perfusion, abnormalities of elastic tissues of lamina cribrosa, and the increased protein concentration of aqueous humor, deposition of melanin, and pseudoexfoliation material. These are the main risk factors for the loss of retinal nerve fiber layer with subsequent glaucomatous damage in pseudoexfoliation patients. Space domain OCT is a rapidly evolving robust technology which provides high resolution quantitative and reproducible measurements of RNFL and retinal ganglion cell complex, having high sensitivity and specificity in early glaucoma diagnosis. So the aim of our study was to see the association of intraocular pressure and retinal nerve fiber layer thickness in pseudoexfoliation patients. It was a cross-sectional study conducted at a tertiary care center for a period of 6 months. 60 cases were included. Presence of pseudoexfoliation material was mandatory, and patients having any media opacity interfering with the visualization and OCT image capturing, high myopes, and patients on anti-glaucoma medications or having undergone any previous glaucoma and cataract surgery were excluded. Anterior-posterior segment evaluation was done. Intraocular pressure was calculated using Goldman applanation tonometry. OCT, RNFL, gonioscopy, and pachymetry was done. A case report form was filled, and the data was analyzed. PXF is a complex systemic disorder of extracellular matrix primarily affecting the eyes and visceral organs, characterized by the deposition of fibrillary material on all anterior segment structures. It's one of the most common causes of secondary open-angle glaucoma. It's a well-known, OCT has a very well-known role in diagnosing the periperimetric glaucoma. So prevalence of PXF increases markedly with age, and in our study, 60% of the patients were females with the mean age being 66.5 years. It was since it was conducted at a tertiary care hospital, the results couldn't be implemented on a general population. Furthermore, since glaucoma is a progressive disease, resulting in progressive loss of nerve tissue with optic nerve head and visual field changes, so testing at a single point in time cannot be conclusive. More population-based prospective studies in our setup, evaluating the changes over time, need to be conducted. Out of 60 patients, we had 36 females and 24 males. The mean age was 66.5 years. And according to our, thus it can be interpreted from the study that there was no correlation between RNFL thickness and IOP in PXF patients. Patients with decreased corneal thickness, central corneal thickness, increased intraocular pressure, having grade 3 PXF and pigmentation in the trabecular meshwork have greater risk of progression from pseudoexfoliation syndrome to pseudoexfoliation glaucoma. And routine assessment and follow-up of PXF patients with OCT will help in an early diagnosis of PXF glaucoma.